During the course of his career, we all know that Mike Marlar has been one of the most talented drivers in the country. But we also know that he sat in many seats and in many cars and experienced all the dirt late model racing has to throw at him. But one thing he'd never done was run a complete national tour. That is until this year, when he hit the road for car owner Ronnie Delk to see if he could win a championship with the World of Outlaws. And wouldn't you know it, that gamble paid off.
Checkered flag awaits the winner, Mike Marlar. Shepard's going to give it everything he has out of turn number four. He's closing. Too little, too late. Marlar wins.
Taking the points lead in late September, Marlar notched 5 victories pre-Charlotte and a remarkable 28 top fives and 34 top tens on his way to his first ever World of Outlaws Series championship. 1 year attempting to run a national tour, one title to show for it.
He got the fast time, he went to the redraw, and he wins here at Ransomville. Mike Marlar takes the checker.
While he had less wins than Madden and Shepard, his consistency reigned all year. But he did win, make no mistake. First victory came May 4th at Cherokee Speedway, where Marlar led every lap and picked up $10,000 for his work.
The Winfield Warrior will win here tonight at the place your mama warned you about. Cherokee Speedway goes to Mike Marlar.
You'd have to fast forward all the way to June 15th for Mikey's next victory, where at Ransomville Speedway in New York, the 6th starting Marlar passed Brandon Shepard with 11 to go and got his second series win of the year.
Yeah, it's been fun so far, you know, and it's fun getting with awesome competition. You know, Chris is having an awesome year. He's running really good. And Brandon, you know, they're always good. Brandon Stout and Mark's team Stout and, you know, all the rest of the competitors over there. These guys are working every week, getting closer and closer. So fun to have such good competition.
At the midway point of the season, Marlar was officially in the points hunt, and he heated up in July, right when it got hot outside. 6 days apart, he won at Deer Creek Speedway in Minnesota and River Cities in North Dakota, two legendary tracks where Marlar was happy to add his name to the record books, winning $10,000 for each victory.
Yeah, you know, I tell you what, that's a cool deal. Just winning at these places up here is awesome, you know, and just awesome racetracks and... I don't think I've worked that hard in a race car in years. So anyway, man, that was a fun race to drive, but there's a lot of times I was like, man, I'm gonna give this thing away and let loose this steering wheel or something. But awesome race, and I guess we got the points lead, so that's cool. And you know, we just wanna go out and race every night and win some races and just run good everywhere, and whatever happens, happens.
He'd get a win at another well-known track when he fought off Brandon Shepard at Port Royal in mid-August.
Mike Marlar has won race number 5 here at Port Royal.
It was obvious at that point that he was in the thick of the title chase from there on out. He narrowly missed out on his 6th win of the year when Turbo got him at Atomic on the last lap, but that was able to propel him into the World Finals with a 22-point lead he would not relinquish at the biggest season finale in short track racing. He may not have led the money won list, and he may not have won the most races, but when the dust finally settled, he did win the championship. And through all those trials and tribulations that he's been through over the past 2 decades, from modified champion to now national champion, Mike Marlar proved he is flat out one of the best drivers in the United States at any level. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2018 World of Outlaws Series champion from Winfield, Tennessee, Mike Marlar.